Hello everyone. Let's suppose you have a camera feed, and this particular camera feed is a traffic camera feed, and there is this incoming traffic that is coming this side. Currently this road is blank, and at some point in time traffic may also go on that side. So suppose you wanted to create an application where you want frame by frame difference between the initial frame and the next frame, okay, that you can do in OpenCV very easily. As well, if there is a difference, you want the foreground to disappear. That also you can do very easily in OpenCV. These are some straightforward functions which are available to us, and that is what I'm planning to show today. So we will import our libraries, and then we will import, and then we will be using that particular AVI file. Okay. And we will use the first frame as a starting point. That frame we will keep in a variable which we will call as average, but this is just a matrix. Okay, it is your first frame, your initial frame. So you will save your initial frame. This is just your initial frame. Once you get the initial frame, what we will do is we will loop over the video, and just let me write the code for the looping part. So you loop over the video, and until someone presses an escape key, you will want to keep on looping over it, and then you release your variables and destroy all the windows. Okay, this OpenCV function which does the magic trick for us, there are two functions that we are going to use. The first is cv.accumulateWeighted. What this takes is, it takes an input source and a destination, and this is the alpha parameter. So let me show you how this function works. So this particular function will update the destination like this. It will take 1 minus alpha, whatever we pass here, multiply by that by the destination, plus alpha dot source, the source frame, okay, x comma y, if your mask is not equal to 0. So we have not specified the mask here. And what this function does is, it calculates the weighted sum of the input image source and the destination, so that the destination becomes a running average of a frame sequence. Once that is done, what we will do is, we will take the absolute difference between the current frame and the weighted sum. Okay, and that's it. And let us do the show part, where you will show the current frame and you will show the change in the foreground. And what I've done here is just use this resize so that we can see it in a smaller size, otherwise it will occupy the complete screen. So you can see this is your main video frame, and this is the change in the foreground. What it is taking is, frame by frame, those pixels, okay, the weighted sum of the input image and the source image is calculated, and the difference is calculated, and we are showing the difference. So the effect is as if you are seeing a video, you are seeing a complete trail of the changes in what is happening on your foreground. Now let's suppose you want to let, due to some reason, you want your foreground to disappear. How you can do that is, we will just take, directly convert this average one, and we will convert it into an absolute value and show this average . Okay, that will be a disappearing foreground. So So these are the changes which are happening here. And if you look at this particular window, the disappearing foreground, after a few frames, it will take a little bit of time. And after a few frames, you would see the shadow here, but just a very slight, mild shadow of the changes that are happening. Right. Let me just modify this particular parameter and show you. You can play with this alpha parameter and you can see the difference in when you increase the alpha, the disappearance of the foreground, you will see you will still find a trail and it will not completely disappear. Okay, that is because of the way the weighted summation is happening. Right, but still it gives a quite nice effect. So I'm not sure where it will help, but probably if you are looking for sources where you have a CCTV camera and in that camera you want to figure out if at a particular location, which is your point of interest, the region of interest, if there are some changes in a region of interest, you can then just capture that particular region of interest, and if there is some new person or you know, some new thing that is happening in that region of interest, you may want to either do some kind of functionality like this one where you would see the changes, but generally it would be a person and you would want to identify who that person is, okay, or what object it is that is getting changed in the foreground. So you may want to identify cars, buses, okay, what is it that is happening in this feed particularly. Okay, I hope it helps. Thank you.